It's the queen of information. This is the Bev Smith Show.
Let me know what we can do to publicize this case, because this is just outrageous.
Empower yourself so that you can empower others. This is the Bev Smith Show.
Reading is fundamental. And we who are of African descent, we owe the ancestors to learn how to read.
Inspiring, motivating, empowering. This is the Bev Smith Show.
So maybe we can get a national dialogue, which is something that we need in this country. We don't want to talk about it. But we go to war over other countries that are doing ethnic cleansing. And what are we doing here in this country?
Ensuring that we continue to maintain the voice of the community. This is the Bev Smith Show on the Empowering Radio Network. Get empowered.
Well, hello and welcome to the Bev Smith Show. How are ya? How are ya? How are ya? Hope you had a great day. I ask you all the time. You should get up in the morning and say, it's going to be a great day today. And that's exactly what we have for you. Great day of conversation. We're going to talk to a friend of mine. He's a part of the Bev Smith Posse. His name is George Curry, former editor of Emerge Magazine, a magazine that someone out there, hello, Magic Johnson. You seem magic, by the way. Congratulations on Aspire Television. Are you looking for talk shows? But I would like to see someone finance this magazine and put George back in charge of it. George was awesome. He was taking that magazine to new heights. He's doing the same thing back in his old stomping grounds, representing the NNPA. And in last week's newspaper article, he wrote about conservatives who conspire to do a job on the jobs report. He says the birther issue, the preposterous, well, I tell you what, I don't need to read this. George is here. George can talk about it. Can't you, George?
Hey, the member of the posse, of course. Of course.
How are you?
I'm doing fine.
I'm glad to hear that. Well, first of all, let me thank you for agreeing to talk to us. When I watched the debates, I said to Brooke, please call George. Beg him if you have to. Tell him we need to talk. Can we talk, George? Can we talk?
Now, you know neither you nor Brooke have to beg. Bev, call, I answer.
I love it like that. Can you find a single, can you find me a single man who feels the same way? Okay.
I'm sure the legions out there, but you're so selective, see. You just don't take them, anybody walks through the door.
Oh, look, did you hear what he just said? Isn't that funny? When is Russell Price coming on? Do you remember Russell Price from Russell's News?
No, I don't.
And he also had a radio show on WOL long before Steve Harvey and Michael Basden about relationships. And we were just talking about how difficult it is for women over a certain age group, and in particular black women, to find a man these days. And that a lot of the men that are coming our way are young men, and they're just bringing a little bit too something to the, you know, the fastest growing HIV community, women over 50, women over 50. So it's a serious subject. And so is what we want to talk to you about today, George. First of all, congratulations on this article that you wrote, Conservatives Conspire to Do a Job on Jobs Report. Before we get to your impression of the second debate, talk to us about that article.
Well, basically, people have been pounding the president about high unemployment being over 8%. And so when he finally gets it under 8%, the people who've been pounding him using the same statistics, as a matter of fact, saying, oh, no, it must be he must be cooking the numbers. And the thing about it is you can't cook the numbers. This is the Bureau of Labor Statistics. These are career people. These are not even political appointees who are basically nerds who deal with numbers. And so if numbers are so accurate when you were pounding him about unemployment of being over 8%, then why all of a sudden it's a problem now? And then you just got this thing, it's just going on, and like it's a conspiracy. They just can't get over it. You know, he wasn't born here. That was a conspiracy. And now he's cooking the numbers. I mean, get over it. Because then if the numbers were good enough for you to criticize him, then they're good enough now that they're down.
My goddaughter has online newspaper, Pittsburgh Urban Media, Puma. And one of the stories that she told me about the other day was a story about, and I thought it was the governor of Illinois, and I might have this wrong, but a governor whose son was at a rally for Romney and was speaking to the audience and said, at the debate, we're going to kick him out of the White House and send him back to Kenya. Did you hear about that?
No, but that's mild compared to all the things they say about him. And that's absolutely mild compared. I mean, let's not forget, this is a person you compare to a monkey, a dead monkey. People compare talking about having watermelon patches on the White House lawn instead of Easter egg roll. I mean, you can go down the list. That's mild compared to the things that are thrown at him. Not that it's justified, but it's not justified,
but it's really interesting. And the moment that they are confronted with their racism right up front, okay, sending back to Kenya, it's in America. I wanted to ask, where did your ancestors come from? Because when you got here, there were people already here. If you were the English, you had been kicked out of England. Am I right in history there, Brother George?
Well, first of all, there was hoodlums who came over here. And secondly, Christopher Columbus was lost. I mean, he was lost. He'll give him all this great credit. He thought he was in India, which is why you have two sets of people today called Indians, because he was lost, bringing all those diseases over here. And then you come over here and you go put somebody on reservation, take them off their land and put them on reservation, which is the same as importing people to do your work and then calling them lazy.
It's amazing, isn't it? And I thought to myself, here is this man who, Romney I'm talking about, who doesn't even have, in my opinion, this is just my humble opinion, the integrity of his father, who was a Republican. Totally different than his father.
Not even close.
Tell people about his father, George.
His father, first of all, was governor of Michigan, was a moderate Republican, participated in the civil rights movement. I mean, that's the kind of man, or Secretary of HUD, showed 12 years of his tax returns with no problem. And a person, that his daddy now wouldn't be a part of the Republican Party because he would have no place there to be comfortable. It would be just like Arlen Specter, who just died. Said, you know, he had to leave the Republican after all these years. He's a Democrat, switched to Republican, been there for about 30 years, then go back to Democrat.
Yeah.
Because the moderate voice has been chased out of the Republican Party.
Now, him I knew well. And right. I must tell you that there were two Republicans. One was named John Hines. And I have two of the pieces of artwork that he presented to me from the Barnard Museum hanging in my home. I had it in my home in Rockville. I have it here now. And these two men, Republicans, were totally immersed in the community. I mean, it wasn't about party loyalty, because the majority of African Americans that they supported at every level, with rare exception, were Democrats. And Arlen Specter, I remember when I first went to the nation's capital to work for NBC's WRC radio doing talk. They started it, and I went there to do their afternoon talk. And I got to know Arlen Specter even better than I did when I lived in the Pittsburgh area. Why? Because even though he was Republican and I was a Democrat, when I called him to get some information, George, and you know how important it is for us to have somebody that we can run some things by, he never said no. He always put somebody at my disposal that could get the information for me. He was a unique politician who could no longer tolerate. Some people said that what he was doing, he came out late because he had an illness. I think that he continuously came out, and finally he came all the way out. What do you think?
Well, first of all, you got people like that, Colin Powell, who thought they can change the party, and it's just simply not the case. And, you know, when you're a conservative and have the military record of a Colin Powell, and you get booed at the Republican convention in San Diego because you mention affirmative action, that tells you how far this party has drifted to the right. And let's not forget, blacks used to be Republicans. In fact, as late as 1960,
yes,
Richard Nixon against John F. Kennedy got 30% of the black vote.
Well, it was a black man, the late Arthur Fletcher. And one of these days, George, we're going to have to have a conversation about this man, a black Republican and a black staunch supporter of the Republican Party, and what the Republican Party under Reagan and Bush did to him. I personally believe he died of a broken heart. But anyway.